Scarf fires are getting in there. Yep. You gotta scarify the potholes. Gouge them out. Don't just fill them in with gravel. Handling Scarfire just fine. I think there's some more potholes up here. A couple more. Yep. One, two. Blow them out. You don't want all that moisture. Pro tip, blow the water down grade. Not upgrade, because it'll fill it back in by the time you get on a tractor. Downgrade should be those ditches. So, and any big rocks that come out of there, I like to kick them back in or get rid of them, because that's the underlayment. You want to get down at least 3/4 of the way into the bottom of that hole. If possible, get all the way to the bottom of it with your scarifier. It scratches it all up, and then when you fill it in, it all mixes together and compacts better. If you fill that the way it is, it'll just be like a bowl full of pea gravel. It'll just wash out again. You need to scarify it. It's like sandpapering before top coat and paint. Same thing. Last one. This driveway is really not in that bad of shape. The Amazon driver's really killed it, but I'm just doing this to mess with my new box plate skids. Skis. I call them skis. Some people call it. Get that water plenty away, so it don't just wander back in. Of course, more is going to build up in there, so. You don't want too much water in. I've done this with water before, and it takes a couple days to heal. I'm still going to have to touch this up after a couple days of people driving on it. That's fine, though. I like doing it. So far, so good. And the loader-mounted box blade with custom skis. Once I'm done with ripping these holes, I'll pull the rippers up and give her a smooth out and see how she does. The skids are holding up just fine with the cutting edge 1/4 inch below the bottom of the skid. Should shave it just nicely. Figure out this new contraption. Bucket angle, I'm able to angle the bucket up just enough to keep the scarifiers above the ground, so conceivably I don't even need to raise the scarifiers, but I'm gonna anyway to utilize the skids. Now I'm gonna scratch it sideways just because it helps to run it over a couple times. Not turned around all the time. Okay? now. And you got more traction. Stuff, you just raise the loader to chest height, waist height, whatever you want. Be lucky. Told you they were gonna get dirty. But she's holding up well. Now, pull these things up. Oh, yeah. I like to leave them in the down position, but they're up. A lot of guys take and flip them around, but this at least breaks things up above the plane of grading. So, whatever. Just another adding to spreading out the material. Not that it needs it, because it's wet gravel. So, well, it's actually 5/8 minus what some of you guys on the East Coast call crusher run over top of 2-4 or 2-inch quarry spalls. It's basically ballast rockets. Yeah, it's a really good road base, but, you know, they beat it up. They drive over it too fast, and I gotta fix it every year. So I pull these up to the third, and it wouldn't hurt to have another setting, but, you know, we all want more settings. Gotta work with what you got. Wanting to get a land plane for years, but for using this thing once a year to grade with, I don't think it's worthy of spending $2,000 on a land plane, really. But you never know. If I get the itch, I know where there are. Lots of I like messing around with stuff like this, my own concepts. I'll do it my way. Always been that way. Alright, let's smooth her out. Might throw it in high gear for this. See how these skids work. Now these skids will be their level on the ground. Put it in. Oh yeah, look at that. Pass. And I go backwards with it. In case anybody's wondering, I'm putting that on float. I think it might be a little too aggressive. Offload back right. Lightly feather. You want it lightly. When you're doing the up and downs, there's nothing wrong with doing this. I do that with bulldozers. Something I do, it works. Now let's see how it feels like going over it. Look at that, no pothole. And backtrack. I'm doing it a couple times. Oh, I'm liking this. I'm liking it a lot. Thank you. I'll drive on it if I want. Handles, fellow GTT member, got me for Christmas. Here's bonus content. Living on country roads. People's crap. Who the hell drinks Pabst Blue Ribbon? Now, this isn't perfect by all means, but it knocks the potholes out. And I like to do my pothole grading in a two-stage process. I knock them out, fill them in, and then let everybody drive on them for a couple days, a week or so. And then I come back in with the rear blade and fine-tune everything. Pothole patrol with my loader mounted box blade with skis. See ya.